this is Carolyn Herforth with The Biz Truth. Sometimes, despite your best efforts, a prospect is gonna tell you no. Maybe their reasons are legitimate, maybe not. So after you've done your best to turn it around and try to get a yes instead of a no, and it stops at no, you exit gracefully and respectfully. So now what? First off, don't beat yourself up. You did the best you could. When I sense that a no came from fear instead of power, I feel like I let them down knowing that I could help them, but you don't need to throw a pity party for yourself. Throw one for them quickly and move on. Second, figure out what you can learn from it so it doesn't happen again. Don't focus on what you did wrong, focus on what you can do better next time. So, for example, if they gave you a clue that in hindsight you wish that you dug into further, vow to respond more intuitively rather than plow through your agenda. Or if you notice that you did most of the talking, vow to do more listening next time. Or let's say that they popped a surprise on you at the end that just came out of left field to justify their no. Vow to ask questions in the future that are going to air those types of issues. And my third and last tip is don't let it stop you. No doesn't mean stop. No means next. Letting a no stop you is the very first ingredient in the recipe for going out of business. So your business relies on you having confident sales conversations, not on SEO, not on your website, not on your brochure, your logo, or your book. So keep moving on, entrepreneur. Keep moving on.